Welcome to Connectronix. I'm Steve, and today I am wearing my Monitor Audio shirt because it's Monitor Audio Day, and we have the Monitor Audio Silver 100 speakers here. However, they are on Pangea stands. Not that that's a bad thing, but today we are going to be building these. I say these, although it says stand on the box. There's two in there, so it should say stands. And if you look carefully, it says that these are literally and utterly useless if you drop them. So we'll be sure not to do that today, but instead we are going to be unboxing these, getting them built, and then set up on these speakers here. So let's get after it. So as I mentioned, we're going to be opening these up today, so let's get these cracked open. If I can get that started. Oh, and I just happened to open it the right direction for the camera too. Look at that. So it says Monitor Audio Stand. I don't know why they keep calling it stand considering there's two in the box. However, oh boy. Looks like a lot of work. Hopefully it's not as bad as IKEA, if you know what I mean. Anyway, take a look at these. These spikes are pretty nice. These are very heavy-duty looking spikes here. That's impressive. So I'm not gonna open up each one. We'll end up doing like a time lapse and make it go faster, but I just wanna unbox all of this stuff to kinda show what's involved. There's obviously a lot of parts here. So let's go through everything that's here. First of all, there's another thing taped up in here. These are the bases. And I suppose I can talk as I do this, but my reasoning with getting these, there's the base, one of them anyway, was that we've always used Pangea stands, and to me, I prefer to use the actual manufacturer's speaker stand for the specific speakers whenever possible. And so the fact that we've had these speakers here and had them on the Pangea stands, I thought, let's get the actual Monitor Audio speaker stands and see what those are all about. Each stand actually has its own serial number on there, which is pretty impressive, which kind of tells you they account for each one individually and they don't just mass produce and spit them out. Some rubber feet. A whole bunch of screws, some spacer dealies, some more screws, some Allen wrenches, like we never seen Allen wrenches or had. I guess it's nice they give them to you, but this seems a little heavy. Wow. Thick metal plate here. Yeah. So that's definitely thick. Well, I noticed from the weight of the box that these speakers stands have quite a bit of weight to them, which is what you want in a speaker stand. So one of the things that I've done, and I'm sure many of you have heard before, is like these Pangeas here, they have hollow shafts, and then I filled these with sand. So they're very dead and dense, and those stands are actually pretty darn heavy. I think I got a 40-pound thing of sand and dumped it into each one. So each one's got just 20 pounds of sand in it alone with the weight of the stand. So I would guess each of those probably weigh about 40 pounds. And then you put on, you know, the rubber feet on the bottom that your speaker sits on that makes it very stable. However, to me, it's always a little bit better if you can get the actual manufactured speaker stand that's designed specifically for that speaker And in most cases, the speakers then will actually bolt to the stand instead of just sitting on top of it, which is nice. So here are the actual vertical uprights. Yep, that's pretty nice. So this is an example where you have that hollow part. You can see in there, it looks like when you get it built, same thing. We could fill these up with sand, lead shot, whatever, to give it some more weight and stability. Otherwise, yeah, kind of ringing. Not that that's really bad, but if they do vibrate, you just don't want the speaker stand to be singing along with the speakers. So, however, one of the weird things about these stands, I will say, is that, let's see if it says on the box, here, you look right there, it says black. So the base, the plates are black. This doesn't look black to me, it looks silver. So, I don't know, I guess that's part of the look that these stands are trying to create with the silvers. Although, these are the same stands you can use on the golds. I suppose any of the monitor audio ones. Although their top-of-the-line platinums have their own design stands. And those are pretty extensive, because they're very heavy, they're very well built and quite fancy actually. So you have countersink screws that go on the bottom and on the top. And then there's other screws that actually do screw the speakers into the stand. However, if you look at the bottom, these don't have the screw holes for them, so I'll just have to use the rubber feet and set them on top much like this, which is not a big deal, although it will be a monitor stand and match the speakers, and it'd be kind of nice to have that. Should have brought the drill in without that would have been nice. Could have saved a lot of time. So that's the base, and you can see there's a hole right here where you can have your speaker wire right up the back, which is kind of nice. You get a lot of people that don't want to see the speaker wires, even though sometimes you pay quite a bit for speaker wires and you kind of want to show them off a little bit, but it is kind of nice to hide them for people that don't want to see them. Or you buy cheap speaker wire and you don't want to show it off, so yeah. Okay. Alright, so let's do the top plate now. Doesn't look like there's any direction on that front or back. So, can go either way it looks like. Same screws on the top as the bottom, so that's nice. Like I said, it makes that easy. And obviously that's where I would have put the sand in if I had any. But if it's just four screws, I could always get some sand later, pull this top plate off, dump some sand in there. And it is kind of nice because those openings were large, where some of those are pretty small openings and you got to use like a funnel and it just takes forever to fill with sand. This looks like it'd be pretty quick if you wanted to do it. And it would be nice to have a nice, solid, heavy-duty stand like that. So these stands were kind of ideally meant for the monitor audio studio speakers, the bookshelf studios that they had. Although those speakers didn't last too long in the line, but obviously the stands stuck around because they're nice stands and they are designed by monitor audio. They have the logo down here on the bottom, so that's nice. And like I said, we can use these for other monitor audio speakers. Actually, I think these would look really good on the bronze, the The ones that are gray with the black fronts. So since these are black and kind of silver, I think that would look pretty sharp on there, like the bronze 100s or the smaller bronze 50s. Go with the bronze 100s. Those are probably a little bigger and better. Go with these nice stands. Okay, so that's that. Now, I see they give us these spacers here, and these would be if to go in with these holes, set the speaker on top, and then the screw goes through, and then that spacer just gives it a little isolation between the stand and the speaker itself. But they do give these round rubber feet, which can go on there, so that would work as well. I'm just going to hold off on that for now. And then we have these screws here, which will go through to hold the speaker on. But like I said, these don't have that. So the only thing left now are these big spiky feet going the bottom. And those bottoms are threaded as well, which is nice. And I was just looking at some other spikes that I had today. Let's see where. Oh, here. So, look at these little speaker spikes compared to these. So, it's not that these are bad, but you think about like going in a carpet, it's only going to go so far, where this is like very nice. So, you know, they kind of like put their thought into the design of this. And this part here I'm feeling is actually rubber, which means it will be isolated from the stand to have the spike with rubber isolation in between, which would be cool. So it looks like these will just screw in the bottom. So you can adjust them, level them, or even do a little tilt back if you want. I generally like to rake the speakers back a little bit. And then let's see, these would go on the top. Yep. So depending on how far you want to go with those, I think we'll just screw them down all the way. We can always adjust them later. Yeah, those are literally pretty sharp. I think they're sharp looking though, for real. That's a nice looking base to that. Come on now. Got some pretty good reflexes, huh? Down here in the bottom, you have the monitor audio. Nice looking feet here with the spikies. Yeah, that's nice. I think it would have been nice to have this part black, but now that I'm looking at it this way, it contrasts well with the silver on the top of the feet. Very cool. So let me set that one here. Let's do this last one right quick. All right. Looky, looky, looky. Okay, I'm just going to finish up putting these rubber bushings on there. There we go. All right. All done. Nice. So there's our stands. All built. Didn't take very long at all. Or should I say, our monitor audio stand. Stand. Okie doke, we got our stands all built. Let's get the table out of the way here. And we'll get these set up. So one of the things I want to talk about with the stands is generally for me, what I have done over the years that I kind of like is having the speakers up a little bit higher, which to me presents a larger or taller sound stage. I don't always like people singing at me way down here, and to bring that up a little bit. So the general rule of thumb, what a lot of people will say, is that you want to have the tweeter at or above ear height. So for me, I always like it above a little bit. Or in some cases, to even rake the speaker back or tilt it back a little bit, which helps project that tweeter over ear height. So for me, generally sitting, I measure ear height at about 37 inches or so, 36 if I'm slouching, maybe 38 if I'm upright. And so what I generally want to do is not have the tweeter right at ear height, but I try to get the center in between the mid-range and the tweeter, in this case is right here, try to get that position pretty close to ear height. That way the mid-range and the tweeter will coalesce a little bit better. Or even if I rake them back, I try to get both of them to blend right up over the top part of my head. And in this case, these stands are 28 inches, and we're talking 38 inches for this part here. So like I said, that's about where my ear height is, 37, 38, somewhere in there. Whereas these stands are gonna be at 24 and a half-ish with the spikes on it. So this would be an example where I would take a stand like that and maybe unscrew the front a little bit, keep the back in all the way. That way the speaker stand will tilt back a little bit. So then, even though my ear height is like way down here, or actually in this case it'd be up here, it's projecting above. So when the speaker is now sitting lower, right? So my ear height, like I said, was at 37-ish. 37 is now right at tweeter height, which it, they say at or above. What I would generally do is take the front feet and I'll unscrew those so it comes back and tilts back just a little bit. So as that sound's coming towards me, instead of being right at ear height, will come up over my ear height. So that's kind of like still this center part here between the woofer and the tweeter, kind of getting to my ear height or just above. So hopefully that makes sense. So in this case, my 37 inches, like I said, is right around here, is right at tweeter level. So if I tilt that back ever so slightly, as it comes across and gets closer to me, that sound is coming up a little bit, which then it's almost as if this part is again at ear height to where that mid-range and tweeter will then coalesce together. So that's one little tweaky thing that I like to do. But other than that, yeah, let's do that. So I'll cut right now and I'll adjust that and then put those stands back into place. Okay, so I have those adjusted now. If you take a look, the back ones are in all the way. This is the front here, and the front ones are out a little bit. So then when it's sitting, it's going to be tilted just ever so slightly backwards, so that sound is going to project up a little bit. So you can see here that it's sticking out a little bit on the front, and the back ones are in all the way. That way, when it's on the floor, it's going to be tilted slightly back. Just a little bit, not a lot, just a little. Okay, so let me move these now. And like I said, these stands are very heavy. Just set these off to the side. And I have my positioning on the floor about where I need to be. Just about there. So usually what I do is have them towed in slightly and then go from that point. So what I'm going to do, what I usually do is actually center, not center, but I make the stands the same. 24 and a quarter. So the stand is going to be, wow, that was pretty good. Yep, exact. Okay. I actually have spots in the floor so I can see where I drop those down. Although I got pretty lucky there. So anyway, the stands are now the exact same distance from the side walls as well as the front walls. And then just make sure they're sitting on the stands the same. There we go. And of course, when you listen, you don't want to keep the grills on. Sometimes I put the grills on because they look nice, but most of the time, a lot of the speakers, I don't even put the grills on because you don't want to have the grills on. You want to see what those drivers look like. So then the other thing that I like to do once I get that situated is I have two levels that I use. And then one is just a regular level, and then the other one is a round level. And I'll set that on each speaker and make sure that they're the same. This carpet here is pretty squishy. So then I level the front and back and the side to side. You can kind of see where it needs to go. Yep. And this might be a little overboard for some people. I just throw them up there, it's good enough, but it's kind of a tweaky thing that I like. And I do notice that for some reason this side always leads out on both of them. But yep, so that's pretty good there. And the front and back is the same. So we're set. All right. So that's kind of where I would set those up and start as far as listening. I did have, like I said, the other stands, which was a little bit higher. Now that these are tilted back a little bit, positioning within the room, left, right, forward, and back, is going to be about the same. I do play around with that a little bit. But from most speakers that I've had in this room, this is pretty close to where it's going to be. So I have changed seating distance from time to time. But I think what you can get from there is where we're at with everything. So you can kind of see from, you know, you're actually standing up above the seating position there, but you're going to see how everything is really equal distant within the setup there. And, you know, like I was saying, this is a good place for where I generally have speakers set up in this room. And so I think that's it. I think we'll wrap up there. This is the setup and the build and the unboxing of the monitor audio stand, not stands, right? And using the silver 100s. But I think I'll close out with playing a little demo clip for you guys. So maybe like I'll find something and play like a minute of it so we can kind of hear what these things can do in this position. And we'll close out from there. So thanks a lot for watching. And until the next one, we'll see ya.